I don't like Adam Sandler. I know that may be sacrilege for anyone who may have grown up in the 90s, but I just don't think he's funny. I know many people point to movies like Punch Drunk Love, or The Wedding Singer, or Happy Gilmore when they're talking about their favorite Adam Sandler movies, but those films are how many years old now? And considering how many critically panned movies Sandler starred in just this past decade, I was beginning to think we would never see a good performance, let alone an absolutely great one, out of Sandler ever again. That is until the release of Uncut Gems. This is easily the best Adam Sandler has ever been, ever, in anything. I may have really enjoyed his supporting role in Noah Baumbach's The Meyerowitz Stories, but I fucking loved his performance here. This is not the typical type of movie that you would normally associate Sandler with, and I absolutely love that. Uncut Gems is not a comedy, at least not in the traditional sense. This is a dark and experimental film that is unlike any other movie I've experienced. And not that being dark automatically makes the film good, but the tone of the movie just allows Sandler to shine. He's clearly going out of his comfort zone doing something so serious and dramatic. He was absolutely robbed of receiving an Oscar nomination. So, thanks Academy, now we'll have to deal with Sandler going back to doing Jack and Jill 2 or some shit. So Uncut Gems is about an eccentric jeweler named Howard Ratner. He comes across a rare and valuable gem, and with this gem, he does some crazy betting, gambling with his money, his family, and his own life. So, yeah, Howard isn't exactly a righteous guy. He's actually something of a scumbag asshole. He owes a lot of money to various different people, and whenever he gets close to reaching an amount of money that could actually pay off his debt, he gambles it away trying to earn even more money. He's a gambling addict, making bets left and right for greed, or for the thrill of it, or for God knows what. And that makes watching Howard an incredibly frustrating experience. Because whenever he comes close to getting out of a hole and doing something positive, he just digs himself into a deeper hole. Throw in the fact that Howard is cheating on his wife, and it's hard to understand how Howard is the protagonist of this story. And yet, somehow, Howard is actually quite an endearing character. By all accounts, we as an audience should hate him. But we don't. We actually care about him and empathize with him and root for him to succeed. Whenever he comes close to deciding whether or not he should pay off his debt or make another bet, you can't help but say to yourself, "Come on, man, just do the right thing." There's a certain charm to Howard's otherwise irritating personality, and I think that's a testament to Sandler's performance for getting the audience to care about a slimy individual like Howard. Everyone else in the movie is good as well. Lakeith Stanfield was a bit annoying to me, but that has more to do with his character and not exactly his performance. Idina Menzel is here, but she's barely in the movie at all. Kevin Garnett makes a surprise appearance as himself, and he's actually quite decent. But aside from Sandler himself, the actor that everyone is talking about is Julia Fox. And she's good. I think most of the praise she's receiving stems from the fact that she's never been in anything before, yet she was able to stand toe-to-toe with Sandler's outstanding performance here. And yeah, I get that logic. Like I said, she is good, but I don't think she was robbed of an Oscar nomination like Sandler was. However, I am definitely interested in seeing where her career goes from here. Uncut Gems is just a very well-acted and well-directed movie. The Safdie brothers created a visual experience unlike any other, sometimes to a fault, as Uncut Gems can often feel like an assault on the senses. The trippy visuals, mixed with a gritty aesthetic and an overbearing sound mix where people are always talking over each other while the soundtrack is just blaring, can often be exhausting, but it works in an odd way. All of these elements keep you anxious as the tension of the story ramps up, creating a riveting experience that doesn't let up until the film finally reaches its climax. I didn't really care for the Safdie brothers' last film, Good Life, but I was very impressed here. In my review for Just Mercy, I stated that there was only one other movie that I would probably have listed in my favorite films of 2019 had I seen it just a bit earlier. And Uncut Gems is definitely the movie I was referring to. I still haven't seen Little Women, so I'm not sure how I'll ultimately feel about that film, but right now it just doesn't look like it's my cup of tea. I love Greta Gerwig and her last film, Lady Bird, but I don't know. I guess I'll see soon enough. But Uncut Gems is a fascinating experience that just immediately hooks you into its narrative. I was so mesmerized by its story that I actually started to Google Howard Ratner after the movie had finished to see if he was a real person or if the film was based on a real story. It's not, but that's how captivated I was by this film. It felt so grounded and real that I wanted to know more. I still want more. So I can't wait until I see this movie again, because I would likely give Uncut Gems 4.25 out of 5 stars. Thanks for watching.